Hey guys, welcome back. So today we got a 2021 G80 3.5 turbo. Customer complained our head-up display, it's not there. So it's saying that after driving and then the head-up display just was missing. So I did scan for codes here. We got a code. Let me just turn this down. Okay, so we got a code for airbag. I don't think that's gonna be related, but we'll just keep that in mind. And our head-up display here, where's that guy? Oh, so it didn't show here, because usually in the factory scan tool it will show that it's either not equipped or no communication. So on an aftermarket, when you scan, let's for example, let's say health report, just watch your scan tool, because that one, when the scanning of all the system was done, it won't show if it's equipped or not equipped. So right now we're gonna do again and scan it, because it will show here that it's either the vehicle is not equipped with that system or it's not communicating, right? So for example, this guy here, IAU, is grayed out, so that's the identification. I know that it's not equipped with this vehicle, so that's why it's just grayed out. But when it's done, it won't show you the overview, right? So on this guy here, it says BCM head-up display, right? So I'm gonna just pause that, because I already show you that one. So I'm gonna go back. Okay, then we're gonna go system selection, we're gonna go to our body control module and head-up display. So let's just wait if it can communicate or not. So it shows here, if I'm gonna do individual system, it will tell me that it's a fault in communication, right? And we know for sure that this vehicle has a head-up display, because if I'm gonna go to our setup, and there's an option there for a head-up display, right? And I just checked there, and there's nothing blocking there. So our next process on this one is we're gonna go for a wiring diagram. Let's locate our module. If it's not on that cluster, I hope not, I hope somewhere else. And we're gonna check our power and ground and check the wiring, and maybe it has individual fuse or ground, so we'll see. Okay, so I know we're dealing right now with no communication with our module. So here's our wiring diagram. There's no other joint connector except going to the back of the cluster. So we have to remove that cluster. Oh, where's the component? So as you can see there, that's in there, the head-up display, the connector is there. So any communication issue, we do our power first, the ECS one. Here's our fuses there. Cluster 10 amp and a module 13 10 amp. So we know that our cluster is working fine, but we'll just double check on our smart junction box if we can find that 10 amp cluster. We got one here, we got one there, or it's too bright, guys. There, 10 cluster, 10 amp, and then module 13 will be 12. Where are you guys? Module 13, 11, 12, 13. So right corner second fuse. So let me put this in the ground. I have my test light, check, I got power there. Let's check on the connection. So we're gonna go to 10 amp, 1, 2, 3, ignition on, sorry, Ignition on. That's ignition on. We got power there. Power there. And now we go to our module 13. And it's gonna be the second fuse there. Power there. Power there. Okay. So after we check our fuse, next will be we're gonna go to our module itself and we're gonna check our connections there. Okay, so let's try to remove this upper trim piece in our steering column, and then I think we just have to pull this out. Just have to be careful on this. So I don't think we have to remove any other trim piece. So, oh, looks tight. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. I have to remove these guys here, but I think I have to remove this. Oh man, let me double check the service manual and see if I need to remove these guys here. I think I have to remove that. Okay, so the manual shows that this cover here, we're gonna remove that. So it's just use your plastic trim tool. Just all clips there, so just pry slowly. Come on. Out. So next is we're gonna remove this piece here, this wooden trim, right? And on this side too. So I'm just gonna remove the side panel here. There should be a screw on the side. Same thing on the other side. There's gonna be screw, and then we just have to slowly pop it out. Okay, so I remove our screw. Just move your rudder strip there, and then you just have to pull. And there's gonna be a wire in there. It's of the LED here. So we'll just leave it like that for now. I'm gonna remove that later. Let's go to the other side and let's do the same. Okay, so same thing on the other side. You just remove your rudder strip and then side panel screw, and then just try pulling it. Because you have to be very, very careful. Sometimes this, even though this is just plastics here, once it's, you know, scratches on something, it's gonna scratch good. Because it happened to me already. I was very complacent about it. Just leave it like hanging. So now I'm gonna start removing the screws here, and let's see when we remove the cluster. Okay, so there should be how many screws? 5 screws around this cluster housing. That's 1, 2. I think the other Genesis and GV80 or the G70s. Oh no, the G70. Maybe GV80. I think it's almost the same on how to remove this, because the setup on the dash is almost the same. I may be mistaken, but I think it's just the same. So that's out. And now we're gonna do the last one here in the corner. Okay, that's out. Now I think we're ready to move this plastic. Is it? Come on. Okay. Okay, that's out. That's our cluster cover. If you guys see that. Next will be gonna remove the whole cluster assembly, because the connector is behind that. So there's 4 screws in it holding. I have a feeling that it's just maybe unplugged connector, because I guess I never replace a head-up display module on the Genesis, so we'll see. We'll see this guy. Okay, so I'm just gonna remove this cluster assembly. This guy. So there's 2 connectors in the cluster, the big one and the small one here. Let's put that aside for now. Okay, now let's go in this front of the steering wheel. Okay, so you're guys now on the sitting on the top of the steering wheel right now. So this guy here, this is our connections. Looks like that's tight. Let me just remove this connector here and let's see what's going on. Pin is okay. I wonder, it's just a connection issue. So let's put this back. I know I always tell when I do some electrical diagnosis that don't remove anything yet, but I think in this case it's easier to remove it first and just do some visual inspection. So I'm looking in there, there's 2 pins. I don't know if it's supposed to be looking like that, because the pin here, I think that's coming out. I'm not sure. So Do I need, can I push this guy? So I know we unplugged some stuff already. I'm gonna try to do some ignition on and see if that module we can communicate. And now we have the cluster unplugged. So okay, let's get back here. I'm already ignition on. Let's see if I can go to our head-up display. Yeah, so we went through, and I just noticed our guy there. As you can see, will it show? Yeah, it's showing. I don't know if it's clear on the camera. You can see the car there, and our head-up display is working now. So I think it's the poor connection, but I'm thinking of these guys here. Where's my light? So this pins here, as you can see there, you can almost see the terminals, right? I'm wondering if that guy was, you know, back out a little bit, because right now we can go in. We have the head-up display working right now. Let me just see if we can read fault codes. Okay, no codes there. That's good. Exit. Okay, so Noah, what I'm gonna do next is, because I'm thinking that this is a poor connection issue. Let me just turn this off. It's a poor connection issue. You know, my light is too bright, huh? Too bright. Let me remove this connector again. So what I'm doing is, I'm just gonna try to push this back end of the terminal here. Make sure that that's all locked in there. Because if you saw my video on that GV70 with the side mirror not working, the harness was too tight in there, and how they route it. And also on the other GV70 with the cluster not working, when we went to do our testing, we plug it in, you know, everything starts working. So most of this warranty jobs that I'm working, especially this new car, if I'm lucky, it's always a poor connection issue, right? And especially with this type of components, because I never seen them fail since they made this type of feature in the vehicle. So now I'm just gonna use a Stabilan 22A. This is a contact enhancer. So we're gonna apply this to our connector and the female, right? Make sure we have good contact there, because all we did earlier was just remove this connector and plug back in, and everything will start working. So okay, so I'm just gonna put everything back together, and then let's scan for codes again and double check our operation or head-up display. Okay, so I put everything back together. Oops, we're just gonna do ignition on, and let's go back to our scan tool. Let's do full system scan again. Last time that head-up display module or system was grayed out, meaning there's a, what do you call that, there is lost communication or it's not equipped with the vehicle. We unplugged some stuff. This some airbag codes, I don't know what's that, but I'm just gonna clear that because didn't complain about that. So head up display in here shows green now, right? So which is good, and still bright outside, so I don't know if you can guys see that, but we'll go to a maybe darker place. Maybe you can see that head up display there, but anyway, so yeah, we did our fuse check first because that's the easiest one, and there's no other way there, you know, to check that head-up display but to remove the trim pieces just to access that connector. And sometimes with these new vehicles with problems, it's either there's a problem with the control unit itself or it's a, you know, poor contact on the connector, it was not plugging properly or something like that. But earlier, clearly I pressed the tab just to unlock that connector, so I don't know what's going on with that one. So yeah, we got on the ABS code for a cluster error because we removed our cluster when we did our testing. So I'm just gonna clear this code and then let's go to a darker area and just see the head-up display. Okay guys, so that's our head-up display there, right? So there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. There's no fix, but I think it's just a poor contact on that connector or on that system. So let me know what you think, and thanks again for watching.